Good afternoon all. First of all, we will start the revision of chapter 7 money. We will write some fill in the blanks in the notebook. After that, we will take the workbook, measurement chapter, then we will revise it. So please take a notebook, all of you. First of all, please take a notebook, take a fresh page, take a notebook, take a fresh page. Let us start the revision of chapter 7 money. Please take a notebook, a fresh
notebook.
Notebook. Please take a notebook, take a fresh page. Let us start the revision of chapter 7 money. Let me share the screen now. Now we can write some fill in the blanks from that chapter. Then we can move to chapter 8 measurements. Are you all ready with the notebook and pencil? Shall we start?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now you can write CHAPTER, chapter CHAPTER, chapter
7,
chapter 7. M-O-N-E-Y, money.
Chapter
7, money. Let us revise this chapter today.
Ma'am, chapter spelling.
C-H-A.
P-T-E-R.
C-H-A-P-T-E-R.
Thank you, ma'am.
Welcome, my dear. CHAPTER. Those who join late, please take a notebook and pencil, take a fresh page and write chapter 7 money. The same I will forward in the group also. CHAPTER, chapter 7 money. And we have first fill in the blanks. F-I-L-L, fill. I-N, in, T-H-E, the fill in the blanks. F-I-L-L, fill, I-N, in, T-H-E, the B-L-A-N-K-S, fill in the blanks.
Fill in the blanks.
F-I-L-L, fill, I-N, in, T-H-E, the B-L-A-N-K-S, fill in the blanks. And we have the first question. The first question is, 100 paisa is equal to, 100 paisa is equal to rupee dash.
1 rupee.
Very good. 100 paisa is equal to 1 rupee. 100 paisa is equal to 1 rupee. So the answer is rupee 1. 100 paisa is equal to rupee 1. Hundred paisa means it is rupee 1. Abhina, 100 paisa is equal to rupee dash. What is the answer, Abhina?
Rupees 1.
Rupee 1.
Rupees 1.
Now we have question number 2.
Rupees 1.
Question number 2. T-H-E.
The
M-O-N-E-Y. M-O-N-E-Y.
The
money.
Money.
U
for
E D.
Use
the money used in
A 100 money.
The money used in a C O U N T R Y country. The money used in a country. I S is
currency.
Is C A L L E called. The money used in a country is called
C.
Yes, correct answer. I T S. It's dash. The money used in a country is called its. The money in a
currency.
Currency. Very good. C U
and currency.
E Y currency. Money used in a country is called its currency.
And this one right?
Yeah. Yes. You have to write in the notebook. C-U-R-R-E-N-C-Y.
Ma'am, currency spelling.
C-U-R-R. E-N-C-Y. C U R R E N C Y currency. The money used in a country is called its currency. Abhina, tell me the spelling of currency. Abhina, only and quiet.
C R E E N A
C U
R
R E N C Y. Okay, C U R R E N C Y currency. The money used in a country is called its currency. And we have the third question. T H E the T H E the Siddharth, are you writing?
The
I-N-D-I-A-N Indian
I-T-H-E
the I-N-G-I-A-N Indian
Indian spelling
I-N-D-I-A-N Indian
Ma'am, Indian first letter I
I capital letter. The Indian
C-U-R-R-E-N-C-Y.
The Indian currency.
Indian currency.
The Indian
currency.
Very good. Indian currency is dash. Correct answer.
Rupee.
Rupee. The Indian currency is rupees.
Rupee.
R-U-P-E. The Indian currency is rupee. R-U-P-E. The Indian currency is rupee. The Indian currency is rupee. R-U-P-E, rupee. The Indian currency is rupee. Now we have fourth question. The Indian currency is rupee. R-U-P-E, rupee. Abhinav, right. The Indian currency is rupee. And we have the fourth one. W-E-V. W-R-I-T-E, right. W-E-V, W-R-I-T-E, right. V, right. V, right. One. V, right. One. One rupee as dash. We write 1 rupee as dash. We write 1 rupee as dash. How we will write 1 rupee? We will put the symbol first and write the number. Write the symbol first and put the number. We write 1 rupee as rupee 1. We have one more question for today and we will revise the chapter measurements in the workbook. Fifth question we have. M-O-N-E-Y, money. M-O-N-E-Y, money. M-O-N-E-Y, money.
Money.
I-S. I-S. Is.
Is.
I-S. Is.
I-S is
W-R-I-T-T-E-N. Money is written.
Money.
M-O-N-E-Y. Money. I-S is W-R-I-T-T-E-N. Written. Money is written. I-N. In. Money is written in. Dash and dash.
Dash.
Money is written in dash and dash. What is the answer?
Rupees and paisa.
Very
rupees
good.
And paisa.
R-U-P-E-E-S. Rupees and P-A-I-S-E. Paisa. Money is written in rupees and paisa. Money is written in rupees and paisa. P-I-S-C, paisa. R-U-P-E-E-S.
P-I-S-C.
Money is written in
I
and paisa. SEPARATED, separated by a dash.
Dot.
Very good. Money is written in rupees and paisa, separated by a dot. DOT. Money is written in rupees and paisa, separated by a dot. MONEY, money. IS is WRITTEN, written IN in RUPEES, rupees in the and PAISE.
Ma'am, completed.
Okay, separated by a dot.
Ma'am, completed.
By a dot. Abhinav MP, completed?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, good. Okay, very good. Is there anyone to complete? John Judy completed?
Yes.
Ma'am,
completed.
Ma'am, I am
completed.
Snappriya completed. Okay. So let us take a workbook, all of you.
Ma'am,
please take a workbook.
Ma'am. Take.
Ma'am, which page?
Page number 22.
Part 2,
page number 29. Yes, Anaya, see.
Ma'am, which
page?
Page number 29. The same page you can see on the screen also.
Ma'am.
Yes, tell me.
I don't have workbook.
No problem. Look at the screen.
Okay, ma'am.
We are revising it, that's all. So please listen to the question, look at the screen. Okay? So just we are revising. We already done all these things, but we are just revising. Tomorrow we have revision test. So here many pictures are there, no? So it will be good for you to revise this.
Please.
Now I will call out the name and they will give me the answer.
No. Page
number 29. See, I will call out the name. So please listen to the question and tell me the answer. Workbook part two. Now we have question number 1. Choose the smallest shape among the following. This already we done. This we are revising once again. Choose the smallest shape among the following. Sarah, tell me which one is the smallest. Is it A, B, C, or D?
D.
D is the smallest. D is the smallest. Very good. Now, number 2. Malvika, please unmute. Tell me which of the following is the smallest. Is it A, B, C, or D?
B. Option B.
The correct answer.
Option B.
Option B. Okay, very good. See, listen, all of you. Ma'am will call out the name and give me the answer. Others, please be quiet. Now we have question number 3. And Hayan, please unmute Hayan and tell me which of the following is the tallest lamp? Which one is the tallest
one? A.
Very good. A is the tallest lamp. So please take page number 30. Megadars, please unmute. Others, please be quiet. Question number 4. Hand span, cubit, foot, and pace are dash units of measurement. Is it a non-standard?
Non-standard unit.
Both A and B or not. Which is the correct option, Megadars?
Non-standard.
Very good. Option A, non-standard. Very good. Now Mohammad Rishan, please unmute and listen to the question. How many hand spans represent the breadth of the cupboard? How many hand spans?
Four.
1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 is the correct answer. Now Daniel, please unmute and tell me the answer. Question number 6. How many cubits is the length of the cloth? How many cubits is the length of the cloth?
Ten. One, two, three, four.
Five. Five. Very good. So five is the correct answer. And now, Catherine, please unmute and listen to the question. Question number seven. The breadth of the window is dash handspan. How many handspans are now?
Ten handspan.
Anna, ten. Very good. Ten is the correct answer. Ten is the correct answer. I am calling out the name. They will give me the answers. Please, others, please be quiet. So ten is the correct answer. Please take page number 31. Please take page number 31. Then Prarthana, please unmute and tell me the answer of question number 8. The width of the racetrack is dash pieces.
8.
Who is telling the answer? Prarthana, what is the answer? Prarthana, how many pieces is the answer? 8. Okay, very good. Okay, let us count once again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8. So 8 is the correct answer. Very good. Now number 9. What is the next one? Question number 9. The length of the box is dash handspans.
Six.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 is the correct answer. Very good. Now question. Adel Maria, please unmute. Adel Maria, please unmute. How will you measure the length of a classroom? Which non-standard unit you will use? Which non-standard
unit? Space food.
Space or foot. Okay, now we can move to next one. Adinath, please unmute and look at this question. Question number 11. How will you measure the height of a book?
Hand span.
The answer is hand span. Now, next one. Maithili, please unmute and look at the screen. Question number 12. How will you measure the width of a book? How will you measure the width of a bed? Cubit. Very good. C-U-B-I-T, cubit. Now, we have question number 13. Anaya, please unmute and look at the screen. Which body parts are used to measure handspan, cubit, foot, and pace? Which body parts we use, Anaya?
Hands.
For which one?
Handspan, cubit, foot, and pace.
Handspan and cubit.
What about the next one? Legs for which non-standard units?
Food, space.
Very good. Now, please take a page number 33. Question number one.
Take, ma'am.
Maren, please unmute and tell me the answer. Which of the following animals is the heaviest? Which one is the heaviest, Maren?
Elephant.
Very good. Now, Junaida Joshi, please unmute. Look at the question number 2. Which vehicle is the lightest?
Option D, bicycle.
Okay. Take page number 34. Krishna, please mute your device. Johan Judy, please unmute and tell me the answer of question number 3. Which of the following is the lightest? Which one is the lightest?
Option D.
Who is telling the answer? I told you many times, I'm calling out the name and they will give you the answer.
Option C.
Johan Judy, tell me answer. Which one is the lightest?
Option C, balloon.
Now, question number 4. Henry Baiju, please unmute. I will try to ask everyone. Question number 4. Which of the following objects is the lightest?
Okay, pencil.
Oh, Krishna Priya, please mute your device.
Pencil.
Ah, pencil is the correct answer. Pencil is the correct answer. Okay, Manav, please turn on your video and listen to the question. Which of the following is the heaviest? Which one is the heaviest, Manav? Is it A, B, C, or D?
Watermelon.
Amadarshan. Manav, please tell me the answer. Which one is the heaviest?
Book.
Manav, which one is the heaviest?
Book. Okay. Book.
Option D, watermelon. Option D, watermelon. Please take page number 35. Shruta Kirti, please unmute and tell me question number 6. Identify the lightest animal among the following. Which one is the lightest, Shruta Kirti? Lightest. Is it A, B, C, or D?
A is the
lightest. Okay, now we have question number 7. Fill in the blanks. Look at the pictures and fill in the blanks with the words heavy or light. Krishna Priya, please unmute and tell me question number 7. Answer. You can see feather and bricks. Which one is heavier? Heavy and which one is light? Feather is?
Light.
Light. What about the brick?
Heavy.
Heavy. Okay. Now let me ask another one. Raya Sakir, please turn on your video and tell me the answer. Second one, age. Question number 8. Stone and paper. Which one is light? Which one is heavy? Raya Sakir.
Yes.
Stone is?
Stone.
Stone is heavy or light? Stone is heavy. Paper is
heavy. Light.
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 Paper is. Paper is light. Now we have grapes and watermelon. Kartik, please unmute and tell me which one is heavy, which one is light. Grapes is. Grapes is light or heavy compared to watermelon? Grapes is light. Watermelon is heavy. Watermelon is heavy. Now we have question number 10. Number the following objects from the lightest to the heaviest. Where one is the lightest and five is heavy. Now, Agnate is only unmute. Agnate, please unmute and tell me which ball is the lightest one. Which ball is the lightest? Number one?
Orange.
Orange. Okay. Number two?
I'm orange.
Okay. Number two? Which ball is first one or second one?
Second one.
And red. Okay, number three?
Green ball.
Number four?
Four. Red ball.
And
red
number five?
Football.
Okay.
Football.
Number five, that is the heaviest. Please take it, page number 36. Tirtha, please unmute. Tirtha. And tell me the answer. Question number 11. Which one is the lightest? You can see laptop, telephone, TV, pencil, and mobile. Tirtha, tell me answer.
Pencil.
Okay, pencil one. Number two.
Pencil one, two, phone.
Phone. Phone. Mobile phone. Number three.
Telephone.
Telephone. Four.
Computer.
Number five or the heaviest one is
TV.
TV. Okay, very good. Now, Riddhi Kanne, please unmute and tell me question number 12 answer. We can see many books. Which one is number one, Riddhi Kanne?
Green book.
Ah, having only one book, green color.
Green number book.
One. Number two.
First.
Number two, first one. Okay, number three.
Third one.
Number four.
Last one.
Number five. Second one. Okay, now number 13. Number the following objects from the lightest to the heaviest, where one is the lightest and three is the heaviest. Evelyn, please unmute. It's not your name. Please change it for the next time. Okay, Evelyn, tell me the first one. Pineapple, watermelon, tomato. Which one is the lightest?
Tomato.
Number two.
Pineapple.
Number three.
Watermelon.
Adam, please unmute and look at the next one. B. Tell me answer. Which one is one? We can see elephant, ant, and gas cylinder.
And
is number one.
And
number
two.
Number three.
Elephant.
Very good. Elephant. Now please take a page number 37.
Big man.
Austin, please unmute and arrange the objects from the heaviest to the lightest. Which one is the heaviest in these four? You can see radio, camera, bulb, and TV. Which one is the heaviest?
TV
is the heaviest. Next one.
TV.
Next one.
Radio.
Radio, number one.
Camera.
One.
Number two.
Camera. Now, last one, lightest one is? Jewel Jomi, please unmute and look at the question number 15. Circle the heavier object. Which one is the heavier one? Is it a boy or girl?
Boy.
Okay, very good. Now, let me see. Sandria, please unmute and tell me, compare the weight of the objects. How can we compare the weight of the objects? You can see shoe and kite. Which one is heavier? Which one is having more weight?
Shoe.
Okay, shoe. So we can say, shoe, weight of the shoe is greater than weight of the kite. Weight of the shoe is greater than weight of the kite. Weight of the kite. Okay, now let us take page number 38 and we have question number 18. Answer the following. If A, box A is heavier than box B and box B is heavier than box C, then which box is the heaviest? Which one is the heaviest here? Which one is the heaviest? Box A is the heaviest. Box A is the heaviest. Now, question number B. If giraffe is taller than a deer is taller than rabbit, then who is the shortest animal? Which one is the shortest animal?
Rabbit.
Rabbit is the shortest animal. Okay. So the remaining we will do it in tomorrow. And after that, we will have the revision. Morning. Bye. Bye all of you.
Bye, ma'am.